This is the last round. Fight!
Don't you want to ask me why Batman is a quarter scale?
Why would I ask that?
That's the question.
Why would I ask that? I know the answer to that.
That's the question everybody asks me.
All right. Do you want to address that?
Well, because... Well, two reasons. One, Sideshow won't allow it.
Yeah.
And two, it'd be too big and heavy to hang on your wall. And while you could technically put these on your shelf, they are primarily designed to hang on your wall. As a collector, I know how hard it is to find shelf space.
Yeah.
But I do have wall space.
Yeah, that makes sense.
I have space above my shelves. I have space above my door, you know? And these are designed to fit perfectly in those areas.
Yeah.
You know? And they're priced, I think, they will be priced reasonably in relation to the size they are. I mean, they're not going to be $400, $450. Like,
so you got the Justice League, right?
Yeah, our license covers everything Justice League. Anybody that's ever been in the Justice League, good or bad, is part of our license.
Okay. That's cool.
And we've got a lot planned. So I hope people like Batman, because...
Any clues for the next one on that?
Well, I'll tell you this. Like Street Fighter, like everything at PCS, the ones that get done and approved, those are the ones that come out next.
Yeah.
But we are currently working on Hawkman, Superman, Shazam, Batgirl, Catwoman, Wonder Woman, and there's one other one we're sculpting right now, and I can't remember who it is. But we're working on all of those right now. All right,
so with one last question on... just gonna ask about Dredd, because I love Dredd, being an Englishman. So you did, like, I have the Judge Dredd, which you did.
That?
I have it, yeah, I have the Judge Dredd. Are you surprised?
Statue.
You surprised I have that?
I thought all you really bought was Street Fighter.
No, I buy other stuff. So I have that. I didn't get Judge Death.
That's a beautiful statue.
I'm sure it is, but at the time I didn't have the money. The bike looks really sick. I love it. But it's huge, and I don't know if I have room for it.
It is huge.
But it is amazing. And then I guess my next question is, like, do you know what's on the radar next for Judge Dredd?
We have...
Would it be a female, by any chance?
No.
Oh, okay, because everyone's kind of like asked about Judge Anderson.
And
you're like, nah, that's a crap statue or something.
I just don't know that she's going to sell what we need to sell. It's not to say we won't do it. It's just hasn't been started. I'd really like to do a life-size bust of Dredd.
Oh, yeah, that would be cool.
So that might be next.
Okay. All right, makes sense. All right, well, I'm going to wrap it up. Thank you for doing this the second time. You actually did longer this time. And we got more information. You're the best, Jerry. Have you got any shout-outs before we close out this video, finally? Final, final, final.
I want to shout-out to Mark Cochran for doing this interview.
Don't reveal my real name.
And his credit card number is... No. I want to shout-out to Brian over at Capcom for... really working closely with us over the past year or so to expedite the development of everything. I mean, Capcom's been great. We've got a lot of stuff coming out, and I think we're really on a roll with accurate, great Street Fighter stuff.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what you got.
Cool. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
You took it away too fast. I always do snarky, and then I'll do the real answer. I also want to shout out, thank you to all the collectors and everybody that supports the company and Street Fighter and Mortal Kombat and everything. And, you know, thanks to everybody.
Okay, guys, that was my interview with Jerry Macaluso at New York Comic Con 2014. It wasn't planned, and I fucked up the first interview, so that was deleted. The second interview, I was... trying to rush through the questions, so I was a little bit pushy, but Jerry's a good sport, and actually we ended up spending more time on the second interview than the first, uncovered a lot of things, and I hope you enjoyed it. Sorry to the Masters of the Universe fans. We covered that in the first interview, but we didn't cover it heavily. He did tell me one thing. He told me that the person who checks the Filmation statues, there's a super secret guy who's high up in the industry who I think, I'm paraphrasing now, been instrumental in the He-Man cartoon, who checks every statue to make sure that it's absolutely correct and the same as the He-Man cartoons. The other thing he said, not related to Masters of the Universe, the other thing he said for pop culture shock in general, is the Instagram photo of the one-third scorpion has a board in the background, which we've all been working on deciphering. And he said, yes, that was a massive Easter egg, and that there are names on there we haven't yet deciphered and not been revealed. So if anyone has any Blade Runner-style software that can enhance and, I don't know, recreate, please get on that. We'd love to know what those are. And then the last thing that I remember, I'll continue to rack my brains. The last thing I remember is he said the next revisit for Street Fighter would be a guy. I said Ken, because I just didn't think he was ready to revisit the quarter scale Akuma yet. He sort of made me feel like it wasn't Ken, so maybe it is Akuma because Akuma was the first that was ever made. But I don't know. I've never felt like he wants to revisit the quarter scale Akuma, so I guess we'll just see, because it's a Grail and it's pretty cool, and it's pretty cool to have that out there as an ambassador for the company. If you like this, please like it. If you want to comment, please comment. I'm always loving coming back to my videos and having conversations with people. And then the last thing is, please subscribe if you haven't subscribed. I really want to make it to 1,000 subscribers, and I really want to keep making these videos because I enjoy doing them. Okay, guys, peace out. Take it easy. Thanks for watching.
Game over.